This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses, annually one of the biggest weeks of the year in horse racing. We have 22 races to bring you, including 13 graded stakes from Churchill Downs. But we're going to start out at Santa Anita, the Precisionist.
And away they go. All came out well. Catch a Flight show speed, but they're starting to line up now as Mystery Train kicks on to take over. Magic Marker's right there. Fury Cup Curry coming through on the inside to join them. Catch a Flight still in the leading group. Motown Men is forced to go wide as they all line up. The pace is good early on. Blue Tone has caught a little wide into the turn, is only three lengths off them. Rousing Sermon is racing back second last. A gap of five to Sammy Mandeville. They go past the three-quarter pole and Mystery Train pretty keen to go on. Fury Cap Curry keeps the pressure on down at the rail. Magic Marker's right there in third, been followed then by Motown Men in the fourth spot, no more than two off the leader. Then we come back to Blue Tone, Catch a Flight in the white cap. Rousing Sermon back of the leading group, but no more than four and a half off them. Big gap of six back to Sammy Mandeville. The rest of them are tightly grouped as they go into the far turn now. On the inside, we have Fury Cap Curry going on with it now. Fury Cap Curry up alongside Mystery Train. In behind that comes Magic Mark. Motown Men goes looking for the lead, and Motown Men now makes a run coming to the quarter pole. On the far side, Blue Tone has been wide throughout, and now Sammy Mandeville coming with a big run. Sammy Mandeville was last, but starting to pick his way through. Runners in the white colours behind a wall of horses, though. They come for home. It's wide open. Catch a Flight. Sammy Mandeville now ducks down onto the rail and continues his run. Motown Men is on the outside. They come for home. It's Catch a Flight. Catch a Flight, Sammy Mandeville on the inside. Catch a Flight holding him at bay. And Catch a Flight and Flavian Pratt have won the Precisionist. Catch a Flight beat Sammy Mandeville. Motown Men was third and then Blue Tone.
Catch a Flight scores the victory. The favorite at 7-5, the offspring of Giant's Causeway, sent out by Richard Mandela, scores by 3/4 of a length, returning $4.80. Sammy Mandeville from last to second under Alex Elise, with Motown Men finishing third in this year's running of the Precisionist. Up next on Sunday afternoon, we're going to have three-year-old fillies on the turf in the honeymoon.
And away they go. Screaming Skylar hops away fast from the inside gate, and Screaming Skylar straight to the front. Spanish Queen dropping in right behind the leader in the center of the track. Here's Spirit of Xi'an in the blue cap now sprinting up to take over. Just in behind that comes Singing Kitty. Entre Shaw in the white cap is only three off these leaders. Pace solid early. On the inside comes Charlotte Ray, then back to Lutine Bell. Prize Exhibit and Star of Strada as last. Eight lengths would cover the lot. They head into the first turn and Spirit of Xi'an goes on to lead it by a length and a half. In second is Screaming Skylar. Down at the rail, Spanish Queen has a good spot in third. Singing Kitty's on the far side, only two lengths off these leaders. Entrechet travels well enough in the white cap. On the inside of that comes Charlotte Ray. No more than three and a half covers all those runners. Then we drop back to Lutine Bell. Just in behind Lutine Bell comes Star of Estrada, now giving them eight length start. They've run past the 8.5-mile pole now, and Spirit of Xi'an goes on, leads 3/4 of a length. Screaming Skylar sent after her second. Spanish Queen traveling well in the red cap at the rail now. Can Spanish Queen find somewhere to run? Singing Kitty's in with a shot on the far side too. Right in behind that comes Charlotte Ray. Entre Shaw's on the outside, and now a Prize Exhibit starting to run. Prize Exhibit looking for room but coming fast. They're at the top of the lane, and Spanish Queen hooks off the rail in the red cap, and Spanish Queen now strikes the front. Spanish Queen in full flight for the wire. Down the center of the track, Charlotte Ray's chasing gamely, shifting in a little, but Spanish Queen in a dominating performance today. Spanish Queen and Brise Blanc impressive in the honeymoon. They win well. Charleray was second. Spirit of Gian finished third, and then came Prize Exhibit.
Spanish Queen with Brees Blanc in the saddle scores the victory as the second choice in the wagering. Spanish Queen wins by a length and a half, returning $8 even. Longest shot on the board at 48-1. Charleray finishes second. Joe Talamo aboard the third place runner. And Trenchant finishes sixth as the 2-1 favorite. Now heading back east to Belmont Park, we're going to kick off the meet on Wednesday afternoon with the Elusive Quality.
And the rough, King Creesa is away well. Plainview is right there. Spring to the Sky, Extreme outside. Now Mosler comes on through as the field heads up the backstretch. And it is Plainview with the lead here by a full length over Spring to the Sky. And Mosler is running in third. King Creesa now back in fourth. Down towards the inside is Mr. Online in fifth. Dimension has moved up from sixth. Then comes Slim Shady, followed by Sinatra, and Tight End Touchdown, the quarter, 22 2/5 seconds. It's Plainview with the lead here as they go into the turn. Plainview, 3/4 length. Spring to the Sky continues to chase in second. Mosler is down at the rail. Then it's King Creesa, and on the extreme outside, it's Dimension, who's running in fifth after a half and 45-1. Mr. Online's going to need some racing room there. And alongside him is Slim Shady. Farther back, Sinatra, and then Tight End Touchdown. The half was running 45-1, and the field is in the stretch with Spring to the Sky now coming away with a narrow lead. On the outside is Dimension, Slim Shady far outside. Then comes King Creesa, and here comes Mosler. Mosler found a seam through and has taken the lead in deep stretch. And it is Mosler on to victory in the Elusive Quality Stakes. Close for second between Plainview, Spring to the Sky, and Slim Shady.
Mosler scores the opening day victory, going out for Bill Mott and Joel Rosario as third choice in the wagering. Mosler, the offspring of Warfront, returns $10.80. Long shots complete the superfecta. Plainview, Spring to the Sky, and Slim Shady, ladies and gentlemen. The only horse above 13-1 at 51-1. Keys the 17,666 superfecta. King Creesa, coming off of the October 18th layoff, finishes sixth as the 3-1 favorite. Continuing the weekday stakes action at Belmont Park, a couple to bring you from Friday afternoon. Up first, the Gold Fever.
And the rough. El Deal is sent out for the early lead. Known as Boy, a Money Changer. Those two are heads apart now. Money Changer is dropping back, and Known as Boy is a clear-cut second. Money Changer's at the rail. Gypsum Johnny on the outside. Accurate is the early trailer in fifth. El Deal leads here by a length over Known as Boy. It's El Deal in front here. After a quarter in 22 4/5 seconds, El Deal the leader. Known as Boy in pursuit in second. Money Changer is down at the rail, and Gypsum Johnny is alongside. Accurate remains in fifth, about 6 lengths from front-running El Deal, who will lead the field to the top of the stretch. It's El Deal in front by a half length. El Deal now in front by a length and a half, now by two. Known as Boy couldn't keep up with El Deal. Gypsum Johnny's on the outside. Then Money Changer and Accurate. El Deal has built a 6-length lead, and El Deal will remain undefeated. He's 4-4. El Deal wins the Gold Fever Stakes. Known as Boy second. Gypsum Johnny was third, and the time was 1:09 2/5 seconds.
El Deal scores the victory for trainer Andrew Lakeman. A feel-good story for you, ladies and gentlemen. Angel Cruz goes to the front with the third choice in the wagering, and the offspring of Munnings never looks back. Returns $7.50. The favorite at 7-5, Known as Boy, finishes second. Gypsum Johnny finishes third. And wrapping up the weekday stakes action, we're going to sprint on the turf, the license fee.
And they're off. Believe in Charlie, Zendaya, those two, right together in the early going. Zendaya takes the lead now from Believe in Charlie. Anecdote is down at the rail in third. Devilish Love, the grays in between horses racing in fourth. Tee Times on the outside in fifth. Then it's Mahjong Madness with Dauphine Rousse and a break of four back to Medaglia d'Argento, who trails the field in eighth. It is Zendaya on top here as they round the far turn. Zendaya, three quarters of a length. Believe in Charlie in second. Devilish Love on the outside in third. Anecdote is fourth, now four lengths from the lead. Then Dauphine Rousse and Mahjong Madness. Tee Time is in seventh, and Medaglia d'Argento continues to trail in eighth. They're at the head of the stretch, and it is Zendaya with the lead. Zendaya's in front, the quarter 22 and three, the half mile in 45 and three. Zendaya by two lengths. Devilish Love is on the outside in second. Then it's Believe in Charlie in third. Followed towards the rail by Anecdote and Dauphine Rousse. They're not going to catch Zendaya, a front-running winner. Zendaya takes the license fee stakes in 1 minute, 9 3/5 seconds.
Zendaya going out for Christophe Clement. The longer shot for Christophe Clement scores the victory under Manny Franco. Goes to the front, does this offspring of More Than Ready. Wins by a comfortable 2 3/4 lengths. Returns $7.30. Long shot at 17-1. Devilish Love finishes second. Dauphine Rousse finishes third. Anecdote, the other Christophe Clement, the 3-2 favorite, finishes fourth. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, weekend action from Belmont Park. I'm Anthony Mormino with Horses and Courses, letting you know that there are some exciting new changes coming to OTB TV. With the new programming schedule and the addition of some great new tracks, now there are more ways to watch, wager, and win. So keep it right here on OTB TV, Time Warner Cable, channel 1250.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
I'm Steve Beck.
And I'm Seth Merrill.
Together, we're Loose on the Lead on Capital OTB, Sundays at 10 a.m. Why should they watch, Seth?
Sit down on Sunday, have a bagel, get some great racing conversation.
Cream cheese only, no jelly. Sundays, 10 a.m., Loose on the Lead, Capital OTB.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Saturday afternoon at Belmont Park. Three stakes races to bring you up first, a very intriguing five-horse field in the Sheepshead Bay.
And they're off. And all five came away to a good start. And it will be Beauty Parlor to make the early lead. Beauty Parlor in front. And Riposte is down at the rail. On the outside is Rosalind. And then comes Maximova and Selenite. Under the line for the first time, Beauty Parlor leads by a length and a half. Riposte and Rosalind, they're right together, second and third. Then it's Maximova on the outside of Selenite. The field is moving for the clubhouse turn. Beauty Parlor shows the way here. Beauty Parlor in front here, in front by about a length, with Riposte down at the rail in second, and Rosalind on the outside in third. And the opening quarter mile was running 25 2/5 seconds. And it's Beauty Parlor who inches away now to lead by two lengths. Riposte and Rosalind continue to race second and third. And at the back are Selenite and Maximova. They've straightened away and are heading up the backstretch, the half in 50 4/5 seconds. Beauty Parlor leading here now by almost 2 1/2 lengths, with Rosalind on the outside and Riposte down at the rail. Then it's Maximova and Selenite. 3.5 lengths separate the five. It's Beauty Parlor still in front. 3/4 and 1, 15 and 1. Beauty Parlor and Rajiv Mirage maintaining that two-length advantage over Riposte and Rosalind, who continue to chase Beauty Parlor. And now they're moving around the far turn. Beauty Parlor in front. Now 3 furlongs to the finish, and now they begin to pick it up a bit. It is Beauty Parlor, 3/4 of a length. Riposte in second, Rosalind on the outside. Selenite, the long shot, looks to come through down at the rail. And Maximova, they come off the turn and into the stretch. And here comes Rosalind on the outside. Maximova, Riposte is there. Towards the inside is Beauty Parlor. Selenite is down at the fence. Rosalind has a narrow lead. Maximova drives up on the outside. It's Rosalind, Maximova. They're 1-2 as they come for the finish. And Rosalind wins the Sheep's Head Bay. Maximova was second, and Selenite finished third.
Rosalind scores the victory under Joe Bravo, who's in for a big weekend. Chad Brown sends out the winner for Michael Dubb and others. Rosalind wins by 1/4, returning $9.20. Maximova at 11-1 finishes second, and the longest shot on the board at 39-1, Selenite finishes third. The 6-5 shot, Riposte, finishes fourth. And the 6-5 favorite, Beauty Parlor, beats no horses in Saturday's Sheep's Head Bay. Also on the card Saturday afternoon, the return of last year's Belmont Stakes winner. Unfortunately, the 2012 Belmont Stakes winner, 2013 Belmont Stakes winner, Palace Malice, scratched out, but Tonalist, the favorite in the Westchester.
And they're off. A bit of a hesitant start there for Tonalist. And Tonalist has spotted the field 5 or 6 lengths here in the early going. It's Juba, who's out for the lead. Pressured here by Confrontation in the early going with Super Lucky on the outside in third. And it's 4 lengths back to the Belmont Stakes winner, Tonalist, who trails in fourth. As they head up the backstretch, Juba leads here by 1/2 length. Confrontation on the outside is second by 1 length with Super Lucky in third. Now 3 lengths back to Tonalist through an opening quarter mile in 23 seconds. Juba maintaining the lead here. It's Juba in front by 1/2 length. In between horses, Confrontation. Super Lucky's on the outside. Now Tonalist is drawn within 4.5 lengths of the lead as they race midway on the turn. The half was run in 45 4/5 seconds. It's Juba down at the rail. Confrontation in between horses. Super Lucky on the outside. The three of them are stacked across the track, and it's 3 lengths to Tonalist in fourth as they come for the quarter pole. Confrontation and Super Lucky on the outside. Juba is now back running in third, and Tonalist begins to pick it up now on the outside. They're in the lane here, and here comes Tonalist on the outside to take over the lead. Tonalist is in front. Then Confrontation, Super Lucky. Farther back, it's Juba, and Tonalist will remain undefeated here at Belmont Park, and he returns in a big way to take his four-year-old debut. Tonalist runs the mile in 1:34.
And Tonalist at odds on for Joe Bravo and Christophe Clément does not disappoint. Sets back early off of the pace, wins by nearly 4 lengths, returning $3.80 in the field of four. Confrontation finishes second. Super Lucky finishes third. And just before Belmont Park took the break for the Kentucky Derby action, they ran the Fort Marcy.
And they're off. Divine Oath away well. How Great now moves up, and Middleburg towards the rail into the clubhouse turn. It is How Great in front here. How Great in front by 1.5 lengths with Divine Oath in second, and Middleburg is next in third. Then it's Mr. Speaker on the outside racing in fourth. Unbridled Ocean is in fifth. A break of 3 to VE Day, followed by Sky Blazer, and the trailer is Big Blue Kitten in eighth. They reached the back stretch. The quarter was running 24 2/5 seconds. And How Great has opened up a 3.5 length lead on Divine Oath. Mr. Speaker and Middleburg are right together third and fourth. Then it's Unbridled Ocean racing in fifth. The Travers winner, VE Day, is sixth. Right now, about 10 lengths from the front. than Sky Blazer and Big Blue Kitten. The half in 48-4. Long shot, How Great leads here by 6 lengths. Divine Oath runs in second. Then Mr. Speaker and Middleburg, and now they begin the run around the far turn. It's still How Great, but the lead is down to 4. Divine Oath in second, then Mr. Speaker, Middleburg. On the outside is Sky Blazer. Then comes Big Blue Kitten, who's down at the rail, followed by Unbridled Ocean, and V.E. Day will be widest of all as they come into the stretch. 3/4 went in 1:13. It's still How Great. How Great in front with Divine Oath. And here comes Big Blue Kitten now and jockey Joe Bravo. Big Blue Kitten has taken over the lead and Joe Bravo is going to sweep the 3 stakes here at Belmont today. Big Blue Kitten wins the Fort Marcy.
Second year they've run it at a mile and a 16th, and Chad Brown for the Ramseys sends out the 9-5 winning favorite, Big Blue Kitten, with Joe Bravo in the saddle, who sweeps the board at Belmont Park where other jockeys were busy in Louisville. Big Blue Kitten returns $5.70. How Great, better than 40-1, the longest shot on the board, finishes second. Middleburg finishes third. And wrapping up the weekend stakes action on Sunday afternoon at 6 furlongs, New York Breds in the Affirm Success.
And they're off. Low Key's Vengeance. There goes I'm Stoked. Captain Sirius is there. And on the outside, it's Weekend Hideaway. I Am Stoked has the early lead, with Captain Sirius in between horses, and on the outside, Weekend Hideaway, a close-up third, a break of 3 to Curious Cal in fourth. Low-Key's Vengeance broke well, but now back in fifth. Then another 4 lengths to Empire Dreams and 5 more to John's Island, who trails the field in seventh through a 1/4 mile in 22 1/5 seconds, a 3-way battle up front. I'm Stoked at the rail. Captain Sirius, the favorite in between horses. Weekend Hideaway's on the outside. Curious Cal will make a 4-wide move coming to the top of the stretch. Low Key's Vengeance is just in behind the front runners. Then it's Empire Dreams, the half mile in 45 seconds there in the stretch. It is Captain Sirius with a narrow lead over I'm Stoked. Low Key's Vengeance is gaining ground down at the rail. On the outside, Curious Cal and Empire Dreams. And here comes Low Key's Vengeance to take over. Empire Dreams moves to second. Low Key's Vengeance pulls off the upset. Empire Dreams was second, and it's a photo for third.
Low Key's Vengeance scores the victory with Angel Cruz in the saddle, returning $25.20 for Mike Hushin, ladies and gentlemen. Empire Dreams, co-longest shot on the board at 25-1, finishes second, and John's Island, last early, third late. Captain Sirius, the 4-5 favorite, finishes fourth in Sunday's Affirm Success. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, Friday's action from Churchill Downs.
I got it. Watch me. I got it. Hey! I got something that makes me want to shout. I got something that tells me what it's all about. I got to move. That tells me what to do.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV Digital Channel 8.2, delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world. Whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita racecourses, no other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Digital Channel 8.2.
Hey race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, and amazing Vegas-style atmosphere, the Clubhouse Racebook, 711 Central Avenue, Albany.
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack. gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And three, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBPet.com. Log on today.
I'm Mark Cassano. Join me Saturday mornings at 10 for Down the Stretch. We'll inform, analyze, and welcome in the biggest names in racing. So join me Saturday mornings at 10 for Down the Stretch, right here on the OTB Television Network.
Friday afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to kick it off with three-year-old fillies on the turf in the Edgewood.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Edgewood. And feathered with a great start, right out to set the pace. Lady Zuzu is off okay too, and Quality Rocks down at the hedge is racing up to be second as Lady Zuzu is pulled off the pace to be third. Sweet Swinging on the outside is fourth as they cross the finish line for the first time, and Javier Castellano settling down, feathered up top. They cruise into that first turn. Lady Zuzu's alongside in second. Quality Rocks is tucked away third toward the rail. Sweet Swinging is out in fourth. My Year Is a Day's racing in fifth. A bit hard to control around that first turn. And then it's B Rockette settling in toward the rail about four lengths off the lead. And Flying Tippet is the last of them all. Backstretch run now. Feathered heads down the backstretch, half length clear of Lady Zuzu. And a composed first quarter in 24 1/5 seconds. So Feathered, trying to go all the way up top, still leads. Lady Zuzu has been second since the start. Quality Rocks is set to strike third toward the rail. Sweet Swinging is on the outside, racing in fourth by another two. B Rockette's going to save ground to the far turn from fifth. My Year Is a Day is six. Flying Tippet is launching a bit from the back of the pack, but is having to go four, maybe even five wide as they move midway around the far turn. Feathered the leader. Lady Zuzu coming with more pressure, but Feather is holding on to that lead. Quality Rocks swings wide for the stretch drive, and B Rockette cut the corner in behind. Flying Tippet on the far outside, trying to get going too, as they head for the final furlong. Feathered is still there. Quality Rocks has been trying to get by, but is still second. Feathered with plenty left for the stretch drive. Feathered is holding on. Quality Rocks can't get by. It will be Feathered, and she goes coast to coast. 2.5 lengths on the wire. Quality Rocks and Lady Zuzu.
Feathered goes to the front under Javier Castellano. Todd Pletcher sends out the offspring of Indian Charlie to win the Grade 3 Edgewood on Friday afternoon, winning by a comfy 2 lengths, returning $10.40. The 3-2 favorite, Quality Rocks, finishes second. Lady Zuzu finishes third. Up next, fillies and mares on the dirt going a mile 16th in the La Trion.
In the gate. And they're off in the La Trion. Tis Windy broke okay toward the inside, but here comes Sweet Whiskey racing out after that lead. Sweet Whiskey on to set the pace. Gold Medal Dancer seconded outside. My Miss Sophia comes away racing in third as Sweet Whiskey steps on it early and opens up. Sweet Whiskey clear by three. Gold Medal Dancer's back running in second. My Miss Sophia's third. Sheer Drama's running in fourth. Frivolous on the outside, fifth by three. Molly Morgan settles in toward the rail from sixth. That is Tis Windy in seventh by another three to America. And a big break back to the late running Interest Free, who's at least a dozen lengths behind a solid first quarter in 23 seconds flat. Down the back stretch for Sweet Whiskey. Loose on an uncontested lead. Clear by three, but now here comes Gold Medal Dancer getting a bit closer from second. My Miss Sophia is also gaining ground toward the rail from third. Sheer Drama's in the clear on the outside from fourth. Molly Morgan is fifth. Tis Windy's advancing out of sixth. Frivolous is seventh. America and a long way back to Interest Free as the field rounds the far turn. The half mile was solid, 46 4/5 seconds. Here comes Gold Medal Dancer up to put a nose in front of Sweet Whiskey. Sheer Drama's right there to the outside in third and coming with a bid. And in behind is Molly Morgan, nowhere to go though. Tis Windy swings wide by Miss Sophia, shuffled back, top of the stretch, it's wide open. Top of the lane, and here comes Molly Morgan, shooting through toward the rail to take the lead outside the eighth pole. Gold Medal Dancer now second, Sheer Drama third. Tis Windy is grinding it out, but is fourth with a 16th to go. It's Molly Morgan in front, reaching out for the wire. Molly Morgan up the rail to victory. Over Sheer Drama, Gold Medal Dancer, and Tis Windy.
Molly Morgan scores the victory. The offspring of Ghost Zapper, sent out by Dale Romans, ridden by Corey Lannery. They score the three-quarter length victory over the 2-1 favorite Sheer Drama. Gold Medal Dancer finishes third. Up next, what is gaining in stature as the premier prep race for the Stephen Foster, the Ali Sheba.
They're in the gate. And they're off. Neck and neck with a good start, so too Call Me George. Here comes Den's Legacy, sent up the inside to the front. Britannico emerges to be second, but it is Den's Legacy who cuts the corner into the turn and opens up to lead by two. Britannico's running in second, Noble Bird is third, neck and neck settles in from fourth, right on Curlin running in fifth, Call Me George sixth and on the outside. Cougar Ridge is back in seventh, inside of Midnight Cello, who's advancing from eighth while wide. Two and a half lengths back to Honor Code, a tap of the whip on the shoulder for Honor Code to keep in contact with the field, about 10 lengths behind as they move down the backstretch, and the pace is not fast up top. 23 and 4/5 seconds, Calvin Burrell and Den's Legacy with 5 furlongs to go. And Britannico in close pursuit, second and outside with Noble Bird into the bit third as they move for the half-mile pole. Then it's neck and neck racing in fourth. Cougar Ridge is now fifth. Midnight Cello's advancing on the far outside from sixth. Right on Curlin is buried in seventh. Call Me George is eighth. And it's still 6, maybe 7 lengths back to Honor Code. Ask for more speed, but with about 12 lengths to make up and just 3 furlongs to go. They round the far turn, Den's Legacy. Here comes Britannico up alongside. And on the outside, Noble Bird is launching a bid 2, 3-1 on the outside. Cougar Ridge is in behind them as the field turns for home. Den's Legacy still in front. Britannico draws alongside, and Noble Bird is fighting on as well. Down to the final furlong. Britannico inside of Noble Bird. These two lock horns with a 16th to go. Britannico on the outside, Noble Bird. Noble Bird's got the lead close to home. Noble Bird, Britannico fights on. Photo! Very tight on the wire. Noble Bird looked to have had it won. Britannico came back and made it tight, too tight to tell. Neck and neck was third.
Two stories in here, one for Todd Pletcher and John Velasquez. Britannico, the offspring of Giants Causeway, scores the victory, returning $4.80. Noble Bird finishes second, neck and neck, checks in third. The 9-5 favorite, Honor Code, who looked as though he wasn't enjoying himself in the first three quarters of this race, finishes fifth as the 9-5 favorite. I'd be hard-pressed to think they're going to go forward into the Stephen Foster, perhaps come to New York and run in the one turn Metropolitan Mile. Over the turf, ladies and gentlemen, going to dash 5 furlongs in the Twin Spires Turf Sprint.
And they're off. Just Sizzle wins the break. Hey Ty racing through toward the rail, Power Alert on the outside, and Something Extra is up there too. So down the backstretch, Power Alert with an arrow lead. Hey Ty running in second, Something Extra's on the outside, third by three. Just Sizzle comes away in fourth, Good Deed is fifth, and Drafted is sixth. Buster Rose is seventh, about 8 lengths off the lead. Then it's Forest Elf running in eighth, Channel Marker. And at the back, it's Positive Side as the field whips around the far turn, where Power Alert is in front of Something Extra. Hey Ty's back racing third, Good Deed winding up from fourth. Just Sizzle comes wide off the turn in fifth, Undrafted is sixth, top of the stretch now. Power Alert in front, Something Extra fighting on, but is a length behind with a furlong to go. And then it's Good Deed back in third, and Undrafted is fourth, and Buster Rose is fifth. Deep in the final furlong, and it's Power Alert in front. Undrafted, strong finish, ran out of time. Power Alert the winner. Undrafted was second. Something Extra was third. Farther back, Buster Rose or Good Deed. Forest Elf was there too.
Power Alert makes every call, ladies and gentlemen, scoring the victory for Brian Lynch and Julian Leperoux, setting a new course record, returning $12.40. Undrafted, speaking of Wes Welker, finishes second. Something Extra finishes third as they set the new course record. The winning saddle cloth numbers, 10, 12, and 11. Up next, we're going to have three-year-old fillies going 7/8, what used to be called the Law Tryon, and run on a weekday, the 8 Bells.
In the gate. And they're off. Super Sax comes out running. Akati's Phaeton is also there, racing up on through to challenge for that lead. And Fancy and Flashy fires up on through to be third. So onto the main track that goes Super Sacks in front of Akati's Phaeton running in second. Fancy and Flashy is third. Promise Me Silver is away from fourth. Streetheart of the Outside is running in fifth. Ms. Money is now sixth. Taylor Rest on the far outside is running in seventh. Callback hustled up toward the rail from eighth. Lavender Christie is back in ninth. Enchantin' Lady is tenth at about 10 lengths off the lead. Three back to Scat Means Go, the trailer, 22 seconds flat. Onto the far turn they go, and it is Super Sacks opening up. But Promise Me Silver is on the move. Akati's Phaeton's going the wrong way. Callback is winding up, taking over third now. So around the far turn they go. Super Sacks trying to see it out. Promise Me Silver is running in second. Callback on the outside is third. Three lengths back to Streetheart running in fourth. From the back of the pack, Scat Means Go swings wide fifth. The rest have a lot to do. Heading for the final furlong, Promise Me Silver has taken over the lead. Callback on the outside has moved into second. Super Sacks is back to third. From the back of the pack, Scat Means Go's continuing to close. 16th out, Promise Me Silver. Callback, Scat Means Go. Promise Me Silver will get there first. The one length winner. Callback and Scat Means Go in a photo for second. Ms. Money fourth.
Should have said on a weekday that wasn't Oaks Day, but Promise Me Silver wins this prestigious race, scoring the victory for Robbie Alvarado and Brett Calhoun. Promise Me Silver, undefeated, untied, unscored upon returns, $12.60. Hope we will see her this summer at Saratoga in the test. Callback finishes second. And Longshot at 39-1, Scat Means Go finishes third. Enchanting Lady, the 5-2 favorite, finishes ninth. And wrapping up the stakes action on Friday afternoon, three-year-old fillies going 9 furlongs in the million-dollar Kentucky Oaks.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Kentucky Oaks. Lovely Maria off to a great start, and so too Condo Commando. And it is Condo Commando taking the lead by us the first time. Angela Day running in second. Lovely Maria's on the outside third. Shook Up settles in toward the rail to be fourth. Money's on Charlotte comes on to be fifth. Forever Unbridled is running in sixth. Therasis on the far outside is seventh. Include Betty is running in eighth. Bird at the Wire's in traffic from ninth. Puka's on the far outside running in 10th. I'm a Chatterbox is 11th and on the inside. Stellar Wind is running in 12th. Ocean Wave is 11th by 3. And Eskin for Money is the last of them all. 23-2 was the first quarter. Condo Commando heading down the backstretch run. Angela Renee in pursuit, second on the outside. And those two head for the 5/8 marker together. Shook Up is waiting in behind, racing in third. Lovely Maria on the outside is inching forward from fourth, up into third now. A break of three lengths back to Forever Unbridled. Bird at the Wire has advanced toward the inside. She's now fifth for the run onto the far turn. Money's on Charlotte is running in sixth. I'm a Chatterbox is seventh, but she's starting to get going. Five lengths to make up from there as the field rounds the far turn. Here's Angela Renee, put a nose in front. Angela Renee now starting to edge clear. Lovely Maria running in second. Condo Commando's back into third. Shook Up swings wide for the stretch drive in fourth. The whip is out on Forever Unbridled in fifth. Stellar Wind was fan six, maybe seven paths wide. Off the turn in the Kentucky Oaks, and Angela Renee digs down for the final furlong. Lovely Maria won't back down. It's Lovely Maria in front of Angela Renee. Shook Up on the outside from the back of the pack. I'm a Chatterbox is finishing strong. 100 yards to go. It's Lovely Maria clear by three, and Lovely Maria wins the Kentucky Oaks. Shook Up was second. I'm a Chatterbox was third, and Stellar Wind was fourth.
Lovely Maria, who gave Kieran Clark his first Grade 1 victory last month in the Ashland, now wins the extremely prestigious Kentucky Oaks. The speed horses seem to hold up very well. This speed horse at Offspring of Majestic Perfection scores by 2 3/4 lengths, returning $14.60 for Larry Jones. Shook Up, up on the pace at better than 25-1, finishes second. I'm a Chatterbox, well back early, finishes third. Stellar Wind, also well back early at 3-1, finishes off the board fourth in this year's renewal of the Kentucky Oaks. We're going to take our final break when we come back Saturday afternoon at Churchill Downs.
Trent
I'm Anthony Mormino with Horses and Courses, letting you know that there are some exciting new changes coming to OTB TV. With the new programming schedule and the addition of some great new tracks, now there are more ways to watch, wager, and win. So keep it right here on OTB TV, Time Warner Cable, Channel 1250.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, and amazing Vegas-style atmosphere, the Clubhouse Racebook, 711 Central Avenue, Albany.
I got it. Watch me. I got it. Hey! I got something that makes me want to shout. I got something that tells me what it's all about. I got a move that tells me what to do.
Funding your capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
I'm Steve Beck.
And I'm Seth Merrill.
Together, we're Loose on the Lead on Capital OTB, Sundays at 10 a.m. Why should they watch, Seth?
Sit down on Sunday, have a bagel, get some great racing conversation.
Cream cheese only, no jelly. Sundays, 10 a.m., Loose on the Lead, Capital OTB.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Now for Saturday afternoon at Churchill Downs on Derby Day. Up first, push back a week in the calendar, renamed now 3-year-olds going the one-turn dirt mile in the Pat Day mile.
They're in the gate, and they're off in the Pat Day mile. Hillbilly Royalty breaks sharp and is right out after that lead. Competitive Edge comes away in second. And toward the rail, Where's the Moon advancing up from third. Gimme the Loot is away fourth, in tight and on hold. So up the chute they go, and it is Hillbilly Royalty in front with Competitive Edge sticking right with that one so far through the first quarter mile. Where's the Moon toward the inside running along in third? And then on the outside, here comes Gimme the Loot punching up on through. Gimme the Loot very into the bit. Fourth and up into third now as they move down the back stretch run. Pain and Misery on the clear. On the outside running in fifth. Lord Nelson is in behind horses from sixth. The Truth Throughout's in Peace and War. She's at the back of the pack about 5 lengths behind with a half mile to go. And Hillbilly Royalty to catch. The half was solid though. 45 and 4/5 seconds. Competitive Edge is a clear second. And is starting to gain some ground. Pain and Misery is winding up on the outside in third. Gimme the Loot is set to strike in behind from fourth. Lord Nelson's back in fifth. Where's the Moon is sixth toward the rail. Peace and War is going very wide, and the Truth Throughout is as well. They hit the top of the stretch. Hillbilly Royalty surrenders to Competitive Edge as they straighten away. Pain and Misery is fighting on, but is still second with one furlong to go. Farther back, it is Lord Nelson as they come inside the final eighth of a mile. And it is Competitive Edge opening up to lead by 3, now by 4. And Competitive Edge, spectacular once again. The 3-length winner, Pain and Misery. Gimme the Loot, Lord Nelson.
The old Derby trial run a week before the Kentucky Derby, now run on the undercard and renamed in Competitive Edge, ladies and gentlemen. A brilliant 4.5 length victory as a 6-5 favorite for Todd Pletcher and John Velasquez. Competitive Edge returns $4.60. 27-1, longest price on the board. Pain and Misery finishes second. Gimme the Loot finishes third. And staying with 3-year-olds, but over to the turf, the American Turf.
They're in the gate. And they're off. Tuba from the far outside off to a great start. Luck of the Kitten with good speed toward the rail. 2, Wireless Future is pulled back off the pace. Conquest Typhoon comes up on through. And Royal Sun is down toward the hedge as they race for the clubhouse turn. And it is Tuba in front of Luck of the Kitten running in second. Wireless Future is third. Royal Sun is fourth. Conquest Typhoon goes wide from fifth. Alant is in some traffic racing in sixth. Nonetheless is back in seventh. Fire Spike went wide in eighth. Saving Ground, another 11 drop in in ninth. Indianati hard to handle from 10th. Divisidero is 11th by 2. World Approval is running in 12th by another 5. Majestico is at the back of the pack. 24 for the first quarter, heading down the back stretch run. And it is Tuba in front on a clear-cut lead. Opens up a length and a half to Luck of the Kitten, who's sitting in second, and Wireless Futures on the outside in third. Royal Sun is tucked away fourth and toward the rail. A Lot is in the thick of things, running in fifth. Conquest Typhoon is going to be four wide to the far turn run from sixth. Fire Spikes Wide Trip continues in seventh, nonetheless is eighth. Toward the inside, another 11 drop is running in ninth, about five or six lengths off the lead. Divisidero's got about nine lengths to make up, starting to wind up Indianati and World Approval as they come to the top of the stretch, where Tuba is still the leader. Tuba's off the turn in front. Here comes A Lot on the outside. Luck of the Kitten is stopped in behind horses. Conquest Typhoon, Royal Sun, Divisidero is flying down the crown of the course. But in the meantime, A Lot got the jump and opened up by two. Divisidero coming with a flying finish. Divisidero coming after A Lot. Divisidero up in time. Over A Lot in second, World Approval was third. Farther back is tight, Luck of the Kitten or Royal Sun.
Rafael Hernandez, ladies and gentlemen, riding for Buff Bradley, guides this long shot into the winner's circle well back early on the firm turf course, returns $19.20. The proper spelling for A Lot finishes second. World Approval finishes third. And Conquest Typhoon, the 3-1 favorite, beats two horses while finishing 11th in the American turf. Back to dirt and grade one action for fillies and mares sprinting 7/8 in the Humana Distaff.
In the gate. And they're off. Thank You Mary Lou was squeezed back a bit at the start. Judy the Beauty off to a great beginning, and Moonlit Stroll was off sharp too. And those two fire out fast as the field heads for the main track. And it is Moonlit Stroll in front. Judy the Beauty second and outside. Thank You Mary Lou up close and on the pace racing third. Dame Dorothy with a good hold racing fourth. Sweet Reason comes away in fifth. Clearly Confused, and at the back it's You Butter. Down the back stretch, Moonlit Stroll opens up to lead by 2.5. Judy the Beauty running in second with a half mile to go. Thank You Mary Lou tucked away toward the rail third. Dame Dorothy is honing in from fourth. She's getting closer on the outside. Then it's four lengths back to Sweet Reason after a quarter in just 23 seconds flat. So round the far turn they go. Moonlit Strolls in front. Judy the Beauty pushed along for a bit more speed. Dame Dorothy is winding up three wide on the outside in third, and here she comes now. Thank You Mary Lou is in fourth, and Sweet Reason is fifth as the field turns for home. Moonlit Stroll down inside. Judy the Beauty between horses, and Dame Dorothy down the center of the track with Sweet Reason fourth and trying to close. One furlong to go. The champion's in front, Judy the Beauty, but Dame Thorey's taking it to her. Dame Dorothy on the outside. Judy the Beauty fighting right back. Judy the Beauty, Dame Dorothy. Dame Dorothy got it on the wire over Judy the Beauty, Moonlit Stroll, farther back, Clearly Confused, and Sweet Reason.
Dame Dorothy scores the neck victory in the three-horse photo finish for Bobby Flay, Todd Pletcher, and Javier Castellano, second choice in the wagering. The offspring for Bernardini returned $7.20. Judy the Beauty, second year in a row, the beaten favorite in the Humana Distaff this year at even money. Moonlit Stroll, longest shot on the board at 18-1. Finishes third. Up next, Distaffers on the grass in the Churchill Downs Distaff Turf Mile.
And they're off. Teppin toward the inside with a good start. Made on a Mission racing up after that lead. Kiss Moon there to the far outside. Coffee Click is up close as the field races for the first turn. Teppin's in front. Made on a Mission running in second. Coffee Click through toward the inside to be third. Kiss Moon's now fourth. Cindiva running in fifth. Grant Elmendorf is sixth toward the rail. Kitty Wine on the outside is running in seventh. Lady Laura is now eighth. Strike Charmer is ninth. I'm Already Sexy is back in 10th. Personal Diary is 11th. Waterhole is 12th. And Solid Appeal is the last of 13 as they head down the backstretch. Teppin in front of the first quarter jump at 24 seconds flat. So Teppin midway down the backstretch with Made on a Mission in pursuit, second and outside. Kiss Moon's going to be a bit wide to the far turn run from third. Coffee Click with a great spot, saving ground down inside. Now fourth, Sandiva's picking through the pack nicely up to be fifth. Kitty Wine is running in sixth. Lady Lara is back in seventh. Strike Charmer, I'm Already Sexy, Waterhole, Grand Elmendorf took a bad step, far turn run. Solid Appeal's on the move from the outside, and Personal Diary trails. As the field turns for home, it's Teppan in front. Made on a Mission on the outside. Coffee Click right there in behind. Sandiva's trying to find a way out. She's in behind horses. On the far outside, here comes Lady Lara diving down toward the rail. Kiss Moon is also there. One furlong to go. Still Teppan. Teppan by two. Coffee Click's trying to get by, but Teppan is digging down deep and is holding on. And Julien Le Perroux and Teppan have won. A length and a half on the wire. Coffee Click was second. Sandiva was third. Farther back, Lady Lara might have got fourth.
Julien Le Perroux sends out Mark Cassie's runner, puts him on the front end, puts her on the front end as the longest shot for the single-digit runners, makes every pole a winning one, returning $20.20. They bet five horses down to single digits, ladies and gentlemen, eight at double-digit odds. The top four, all single digits. Coffee Click, the 5-2 favorite, finishes second. Sandiva finishes third. Lady Lara checked in fourth in the Churchill Distaff Turf Mile. Up next, the return of the Breeders' Cup Classic champion in the Churchill Downs.
In the gate. And they're off. Wasn't the best of starts for Byron. Off to the back of the pack. Private Zone hits the ground running. Right out after that lead, Nate's Mineshaft on the outside in second, and Byron is stuck in behind. Racing in third on the outside of CZ, who's now fourth. Gentleman's Bet in the clear in fifth, and Pants on Fire pushed on for more speed to keep up at the back of the pack. Down the backstretch run. Private Zone in front narrowly. Nate's Mineshaft on the outside in second, and Byron continues in some traffic. In behind, Private Zone racing third. CZ is fourth as the field hits the far turn, and Private Zone's quarter was only 22 1/5 seconds. So they round the far turn. It's Private Zone in front. Nate's Mineshaft second at outside. Two lengths back to Gentleman's Bet, who's taken over third. Byron is back to fourth. Four lengths to make up from there. Asks for more speed, but is struggling toward the rail. Pants on Fire is winding up from fifth. Top of the lane now. Private Zone surrenders to Nate's Mineshaft, who's in front with one furlong to go. But Private Zone's not done yet. And Private Zone is back in front with a furlong to go. Nate's Mineshaft, Pants on Fire, then it's Gentleman's Bet. Byron's fading through the stretch, 100 yards to go. And Private Zone's gonna go start to finish to win it by three. Nate's Mineshaft, Pants on Fire, and Gentleman's Bet.
But Private Zone, trained by Jorge Navarro, ridden by Martin Pedroza, goes to the front as the second choice in the wagering. The offspring of Macho Uno wins by a comfortable 4 1/4 lengths, returning 740, but more than twice the price of any other horse at 29-1. Nate's Mineshaft finishes second. Pants on Fire finishes third. Byron doesn't beat a horse at 4-5. Now to the 9-furlong Grade 1 Woodford Reserve.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Woodford Reserve Turf Classic. And Chocolate Ride off to a stutter step start and is last in the first 16th. Sky Captain comes out to take the lead and opens up just like that to lead by two. Umgio moves up on the outside for second. Jack Milton in a bit tight there is Jack Milton. Chocolate Ride trying to recover from that slow start, but is going to get stuck wide. Grand Arch is forging up on through two. So the field heads for that first turn, quarters up at 24-2. It's Umgio on the outside of Sky Captain. Those two go 1-2. Chocolate Ride on the outside is third. Grand Arch settles into fourth, while Jack Milton gets a great spot down inside, running in fifth. Then it's Slumber back in sixth. Optimizer is seventh. Seek Again is running in eighth by five. And Finnegan's Wake is the last of them all. Heading down the backstretch run, and it is Sky Captain the leader. Umgio second on the outside, just 3/4 length behind, with Chocolate Ride stalking them to their outside in third, inside of 4 furlongs to go now. Jack Milton has moved off the rail for fourth. Optimizer's going to sneak through toward the inside running in fifth. Slumber's on the move on the far outside, so to Seek Again. Grand Arch has shuffled back to the pack of the leading group, and a break of four back to Finnegan's Wake as the field rounds the far turn. Here comes Umgio coming after Sky Captain. Jack Milton swings up four wide, Chocolate Ride five wide. Seek Again is stacked in behind horses. Optimizer cut the corner off the turn. On the far outside, it's Grand Arch and Finnegan's Wake heading for the final furlong. Sky Captain is still there. Jack Milton coming hard on the outside, and so too is Finnegan's Wake from last on the far outside, and Seek Again's coming on through too. Sky Captain, Jack Milton, Finnegan's Wake, Seek Again, here's the wire, too tight to tell. Finnegan's Wake, Sky Captain, and Jack Milton, all three noses on the wire.
In a very exciting race, Finnegan's Wake, who was last at the top of the stretch, scores the victory by a head, returning $9.40 as the favorite for Peter Miller and Victor Espinoza. Sky Captain, who won the photo for second, was disqualified for the interference with Seek Again. Jack Milton put up for second, Seek Again put up for third in the 28th running of the Woodford Reserve. And about 2 hours later, they ran the Kentucky Derby.
And they're off in the Kentucky Derby. An American Pharoah got away very well from that outside post. Dortmund did too. Toward the inside, there's Carpe Diem up close. Danzig Moon showing speed too. Firing Line on the outside. In the shadow of the Twin Spires, the Derby field races for the clubhouse turn. And Dortmund is in front. Firing Line on the outside is racing in second. And American Pharoah's on the outside in third. Carpe Diem is running in fourth. Bolo comes on to be fifth. Danzig Moon pulled back in behind. Horses running in sixth. Then it's Mr. Z from seventh. Ocho, Ocho, Ocho. Eighth and on the inside. Ten Senders running in ninth. Upstart three wide in tenth. Mupta Hidge settles in toward the rail from 11th. It's a Knockout is running in 12th. Materiality is 13th. Frosted is 14th. War Story is 15th by three. And then it's Fermento running third to last with Keen Ice. And the late running far right is the last of them all. Down the backstretch at Churchill Downs, the first half mile was just 47 and 1/5 seconds of the long-legged Dortmund. With 5 furlongs to go, pressed along by Firing Line. They're a half a length apart with just outside of a half mile to go. A break of 2 lengths back, American Pharoah is 3 wide, racing third to the far turn run. Carpe Diem is running along in fourth. Danzig Moon is now fifth. Ocho, Ocho, Ocho putting in a bid, sixth and toward the inside. And then it's Bolo running in seventh. Mupta Hidge coming under pressure from eighth. Mr. Z, it's a Knockout. Frosted is starting to warm up, but he's going very wide as the field rounds the far turn. And Firing Line's in front. But American Pharoah is looming up on the far outside. And Dortmund is digging down toward the rail. And these three are off the turn together. Dortmund cut the corner. American Pharoah went wide. And Firing Line is firing between those two. Heading to the final furlong of the Kentucky Derby. American Pharoah on the outside. Firing Line hanging tough from the back of the pack. It's Frosted. Dortmund down toward the rail. 16th to go. And American Pharoah and Firing Line. And it's American Pharoah pulling away late. American Pharoah rules the Derby. Firing Line, Dortmund, and Frosted were second, third, and fourth.
And Victor Espinoza becomes the first jockey to win the Woodford Reserve and the Kentucky Derby the same year. Almost not the same day, but American Pharoah, a brilliant performance, high-quality training job for Bob Baffert. He wins his fourth, matching Wayne Lucas in the modern era, or my era. American Pharoah, sitting on the outside of the early pace, scores the popular victory, returning $7.80, making it three consecutive favorites winning the Kentucky Derby. Firing Line, great training job by Simon Callahan, just not good enough, and finishes second. Dortmund, the pace setter, holds on for third. Ladies and gentlemen, they bet four horses down to single digits. You're looking at three of them. Carpe Diem, the other one, finishes, 10th in the field of 18. We had multiple scratches the day of the race, but American Pharoah, really just brilliant, brilliant since his career debut. He was laid off from September to the winter. Two brilliant races at Oaklawn Park, and then now winning this year's Kentucky Derby. That wraps up this week's stakes action on HNZ, ladies and gentlemen. The little quiet week before we get to Preakness Week, but enjoy all your stakes action from around the country and join us next time on Horses and Courses.